Hello people, this is Sonali, the Melodramatic Bookworm. If you've been here before, welcome back. And if you're new to my channel, welcome to the Melodramatic Bookworm family. I'm here today with the Honest Booktuber book tag. I was tagged to do this by Maya from Bookshot. Please go check out her channel. She makes some amazing content related to blogging and books and a whole lot more. Thank you, Maya, for this tag. I am super excited to do this. So since my tagline literally has the word honesty in it, because I usually give my honest opinions about books or movies or anything for that matter, and I thought this tag was going to be a piece of cake for me, and I'm hoping it's going to be a piece of cake, but maybe I shouldn't have such expectations right from the get-go, because life has a way of throwing curveballs at you. One big curveball is just ending 2020. Nobody saw that coming. Nobody saw it coming that we will be in this situation right now. And I'm so glad it's almost over, that we are in the last month of 2020, and super excited. I spoke about this whole ending 2020 and starting 2021 on a new hope, new note in a recent Coffee Talk video. If you'd like to go check that out, link here as well as in the description box below. So without any further ado, let's get into this video and let me share with you my answers to the Honest Booktuber tag. Question number one. Have you ever lied about reading a book? Absolutely not. I do not lie about reading a book, because what's there to lie about it? If I haven't read it, I haven't read it. There's nothing to be ashamed about. Although there are people on the internet who think that shaming people for their choices is a good thing. And question number two, have you ever avoided a book because of controversy around the content or author? Absolutely. Like, if an author is problematic or if they're hurting a particular section of people, I tend to stay away from that author, because no, I'm not going to be picking that author up. And of late, it feels like a lot of such authors are coming to light. Two of them, which were my absolute favorites, they blew up this year. And one of them, it was not like only this year that she showed it all. It had been coming for a while, but the other one I was really not expecting. The one that had been coming was J.K. Rowling. She who must not be named. And then the other was Chimamanda Ngozi Adichie. She came out in support of J.K. Rowling and said that what she said was reasonable. I mean, given all we know about her views on intersectional feminism, maybe we should have seen it coming. I mean, I'm going to dig my claws into it, this whole issue, okay? But yes, I do have a review that went up pretty recently, I think in November, about the books or series that I will never read. And if you'd like to go check that out, I'll leave the link here as well as in the description box below. Question number three. Have you ever been sent a book for free and not disclosed it? See, the thing is, I have been in the book community for a while now. I joined BookTube in February 2018, but I've been part of the blogging community from earlier than that. And even when I used to post reviews over there, I used to mention that I got such and such book for free for in exchange for an honest review. I just think that I need to put it out there for whatever reason. And on BookTube, I have taken to mentioning it on every single book that I have received from an author or a publisher or a gift or anything that is. If you watch my book haul videos, you will see that I usually tell you that such and such person gifted it to me, and if publishers sent it to me. So that's how I roll. I usually mention that I get a book for free if I get it for free. Question number four. Have you ever bought a book with no intention of reading it? I mean, like, this is like a personal attack on me. The point is, I get excited about any book for that matter with the intention of reading it. Like, for example, if I'm looking at a book on Amazon right now, I'll be like, okay, this sounds so interesting, so I'm going to buy it because I will read it. But then again, my TBR is a testament to the fact that that does not happen. So basically what happens is, I buy books with the intention of reading them and then don't end up reading them for like 6,000 years. That just happens. That's a side effect of being a bookworm and a book hoarder. Can't do anything about it. I'm really sorry. Question number 5. Have you ever got caught up in booktube drama? I don't think so, and not that I know of. Like, I have two answers for that. See, I don't usually pick up fights. I try to be as polite as I can. But if someone is being rude to me, then I will not take that lying down. I am not going to sit back and watch you badmouth me or my friends or anybody on the internet who has not said anything offensive to you. And I am not going to keep quiet about it. So other than that kind of drama, I don't usually get caught up in booktube drama. No, it's just not my thing. Question number 6 is an extension of the 5th one, I feel like. But the question is, have you ever had a hate comment and did you respond? Oh boy, I want to say that I've never had a hate comment. But being on social media, being on YouTube and not getting hate comments is like the impossible only. I did a video on Minecamp, my reaction, and there are people who think that I don't know what I'm talking about. There are so many people who commented on that saying that Hitler was made out to be like that because of the Soviets or because of the Allies, or it's all propaganda, he had mental health issues. And I tried to tell them, like, please be polite, don't assume things, you're mansplaining things, you're not treating a woman right on the internet. You see a woman talking about politics and you go immediately, oh, I have to teach her something because she doesn't know anything. And that whole video, it's still getting attention for some weird reason. And if you type Mein Kampf review, you will see my video in the first page itself. Like, in the first few videos, my video appears. And I'm like, dude, he was a dictator, he killed millions of people. What? Why are you defending him? And I don't even get that concept sometimes. And I went off on a huge other tangent, I feel like. Those were belittling. Those were condescending. The proper hate comment that I got was when I did a movie review, a rant review of the movie Saho. And there were quite a few people who came up and commented on the video saying, you are an idiot, you are not an intellectual, you have no brains because you did not understand the movie, it was so intricate and all that. And I'm like, I mean, okay if you loved the movie, but you don't have to call me names, no. And I blocked them, and life has been good ever since. I mean, not technically, but you get my point. Question number 7. Have you ever made a video just because you knew it would get views? Just because I knew it would get views and I made that video doesn't mean it got views. Because there have been videos which I've been super excited about to put out into the world, and they just fizzled down like mad. And there are videos which I'm just put up as part of a routine and they simply blew up. And I'm not complaining because I love that. I love that the videos like get views and that people are watching them, because it makes me so happy. But see, that's the whole point of YouTube. You make videos to reach more people, and when you reach more people, you get views. And when you get views and YouTube picks up on your channel, on your content, then it pushes you to more people and more views. So that's a kind of a cycle that happens. So, but somewhere it's there that every video that I make needs to reach more people. It needs to perform well. But I do make sure that I enjoy every single video that I make. I make videos in conjunction with the videos that I think will work. So there's always this thing where I'm having fun while trying to make sure that this video will reach more people and that the topic is something that I'm really passionate about. I don't think I've ever made a video which I am really not passionate about. I put my all into every single video and every single edit that I do. And I don't know what else to say. I think I've spoken enough about this question. But yes, that is how motivation stays with me. And for a YouTube content creator, I feel like that is really important. Motivation. Question number 8. If you could go back to the beginning of your channel, would you do anything differently? See, for starters, I would do my introduction video differently, way differently, because I hate it now. I know it was a beginning and I didn't know how to be in front of the camera and all that, but still, I would have done it very differently. I would have done the BookTube newbie tag, and I would see, technically I'm saying a lot of I words, but I think that even if I had started, or even if I had done things differently, the growth that I am seeing, it would have been the same in the years that I've been on BookTube. So all I can say is maybe I'm thankful for the way I started, because I've had the chance to learn, to grow, to understand YouTube better, to understand myself and my taste in books better, and the way I do my reviews, that's also changed a lot, and I actually love that about myself, about the way I review books and the way I talk about books. And I've gotten more free in front of the camera, so I feel like other than those two, I wouldn't change much about the way my channel started, except perhaps also lighting. If I had the knowledge I have now of lighting, then I would have made a setup very differently to what I had back then, because I used to just sit down anywhere and start filming. That no. Question number 9. Are there any channels you wish you could be more like? See, that is the thing. If I wish I were more like other channels, then I wouldn't be me. I would lose my own identity. They have their own identity. They have their own USPs about what they do. And I have my own USP. I have my own melodrama to deal with. And I don't want to lose that. I'm just gotten to that point where I'm a little confident about myself. And I feel like the way I am, I kind of like that right now. I kind of like where my channel is right now. I kind of like where my reading is at right now. And I wouldn't give that up. But I do get inspired by a lot of creators on BookTube who inspire me on a daily basis. For example, there's Avni from Books Amaze, Meera Nair, Anchal from Libro Review, Sankalpita from Book Geeks India. There's Jessie the Reader, Haley in Bookland, A Clockwork Reader, What's Booking, Shalu Walia, Little Book Owl, Meena Reads, Zoe's All Booked, Irish Reader, and there are so many more. And I really feel a little bad for not being able to take all the names of all the channels that have inspired me. But I will be coming up with a fresh series on my channel soon where I talk about the creators who inspire me on a daily basis, and I think you should keep an eye out for that. The 10th and the last question is, what's something you love about your channel? I love how it has grown. I love how I have improved, and I know what to do for my channel and how to look after it, how to make it better. Maybe sometimes I lose my way. It happens thrice a month where I'm like, where am I going with this? But then it takes some time, but I usually come back on track. But I keep going, and I think that there are a lot of ideas that I'm yet to implement and that I'm yet to put out on my channel for all of you to see. But as time has passed, I have found a schedule just for BookTube, which actually works for me. And I keep chipping away at it. I keep working at it. And I think that consistency has made my channel grow the way it has in the past year. Every kind of wood there is, I'm touching. But yes, that's what I love most about my channel, about how much improvement I've seen in myself. And sometimes, you know, that's the most difficult thing to see. Improvement in yourself, the good in yourself. And for me to see the improvement in myself, despite the state of mind that I've been in 2020, that's something else altogether, and I love that. And I hope that the growth, the improvement will not stop, and that I get better and better and better, and I put out better content for you people to see so that you can enjoy. If you do, I hope you do. So that was my honest BookTuber tag. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. I hope I did not bore you a lot. I might have a little, but I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you enjoyed listening to my answers to these questions. Consider yourself tagged if you want to do this. It's open. welcome to the party. If you'd like to do this tag, I'll leave the questions in the description box below. Please go ahead, do it. I'd love to see it. And please comment down below what are the answers to your questions. Even if it's not related to BookTube, maybe blog or Bookstagram or anything for that matter, anything that these questions apply to in your life. I'd love to chat with you in the comments. And I'm looking forward to hear your thoughts on this video. And I think that's it. If you like this video, please like it and share it to spread the word. And if you like my content and would like to see more from me, don't forget to hit subscribe and click on the bell icon beside the subscribe button to get notified as and when I post new videos. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Until next time, keep reading, keep watching, and add Melodrama to your life.